Ballistic Missile Defense, or BMD, is one of the most difficult technological challenges in a battlefield. It's like hitting a bullet with another bullet. It requires high-end tracking sensors, a powerful fire control system, and potent interceptor missiles to work together. Only a few nations have been able to develop and deploy BMD. In this video, Defense Updates list the top 7 ballistic missile defense systems in the world. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. India's BMD is a two-tier system. It consists of the PAD, or Prithvi Air Defense, which will intercept missiles at exo-atmospheric altitudes of 50 to 80 kilometers, or 31 to 50 miles, and the AAD, or Advanced Air Defense Missile, for an interception at endo-atmospheric altitudes of up to 30 kilometers, or 19 miles. The Prithvi Air Defense was built with a Prithvi interceptor. Later, the Pradyumna interceptor was developed from the Prithvi interceptor. Pradyumna is a two-stage missile with a maximum interception altitude of 80 kilometers or 50 miles. Guidance is provided by an internal navigation system with mid-course updates from Swordfish Long-Range Tracking Radar, or LRTR, and active radar homing in the terminal phase. LRTR is the target acquisition and fire control radar for the PAD. It's an active phased array radar, having the capability to track 200 targets at a range of 1,500 kilometers, or 930 miles. PAD has the capability to engage the 3,000 kilometer, or 1,900 mile, class of ballistic missiles at a speed of Mach 5, so it can provide protection against medium-range ballistic missiles and intermediate-range ballistic missiles. In July, the AD-1 interceptor for AAD was tested. AD-1 is designed to intercept incoming missiles fired from a distance of 5,000 kilometers or 3,100 miles and is expected to be operational soon. The American Patriot Air Defense System is an all-weather, tactical, mobile air defense system. The system has the ability to engage against cruise missiles, drones, different types of aircraft, as well as tactical ballistic missiles. The Patriot PAC-3 uses a passive electronically scanned array radar. The radar has a range of more than 160 kilometers or 100 miles. The system was introduced with MIM-104A interceptor. Progressively upgraded missiles were added like MIM-104B, also known as PAC-1, and MIM-104C, known as PAC-2. The latest one is the PAC-3 MSE. The range and operational altitude vary depending on the missile type. For aerial targets like aircraft and drones, the PAC-3 MSE missile has an engagement range of 120 kilometers or 75 miles, whereas for ballistic missiles, it has a range of about 60 kilometers or 37 miles. Aegis Combat System is designed by the United States Department of Defense, Missile Defense Agency, to protect against short and intermediate range ballistic missiles. It's devised to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to re-entry. Aegis warships can shoot down enemy ballistic missiles by using the ANSPY-1 radar and standard missiles. The centerpiece of the Aegis systems is a very powerful multi-purpose ANSPY-1 radar. The high power of 6 megawatts enables it to simultaneously track over 100 targets and guide missiles. The four fixed arrays of SPY direct electromagnetic beams in all directions concurrently and continuously, unlike traditional search radars which have rotating antennas that can track a target once during every 360-degree sweep. The interceptor missile includes variants of SM-3 and SM-6. SM-3 is an exo-atmospheric missile defense interceptor used for theater ballistic missile defense. It uses a hit-to-kill kinetic kill vehicle to intercept ballistic missiles during the mid-course of their flight path. In a test in 2020, an SM-3 Block 2A missile, which is a joint development project between Raytheon and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, successfully destroyed a Mach Intercontinental Ballistic Missile, or ICBM, target. SM-6 is a 3-in-1 weapon that can perform anti-air warfare, ballistic missile defense, and anti-surface warfare. It has a max speed of Mach 3.5 and a range of 230 miles or 370 kilometers when launched against aerial targets from the surface. THAAD is a United States Army anti-ballistic missile system which is designed to shoot down short, medium, and intermediate-range ballistic missiles in their terminal phase. It is strictly a ballistic missile defense system and not designed for general air defense duties like defense against aircraft. THAAD is engineered to defend against ballistic missiles in challenging scenarios, like even if the rival launches a barrage of missiles and simultaneous interception of multiple missiles is required. The primary guidance system is the Raytheon Systems AN-TPY-2 Ground-Based Radar (GBR). The AN-TPY-2 Surveillance Transportable Radar, also called the Forward-Based X-Band Transportable (FBXT), is a long-range, very high-altitude, active electronically scanned array surveillance radar. It possesses a range of 2,900 miles or 4,700 kilometers. THAAD can also be cued by military satellites such as Brilliant Eyes. The Battle Manager is the brain for the system, and it extrapolates the information received by it, predicts the path of the incoming missile, and directs interceptors against it. The platform can seek and lock onto incoming targets, moving up to 17,000 miles per hour, or Mach 22. The interceptor missile is equipped with a single-stage solid-fuel rocket motor with thrust vectoring and has a speed of Mach 8.24, or 2.8 kilometers per second. It has an operational range of 200 kilometers, or around 125 miles, and a flight altitude of 150 kilometers, or 93 miles. The missile has no explosives and uses hit-to-kill approach. It has a kinetic kill vehicle to knock out incoming missiles. Arrow 3 is the most advanced system of the Arrow family and is designed to take out ballistic missiles, including intercontinental ballistic missiles (ICBMs). The system has three components: sensors, a battle management center, and an interceptor missile. The main sensor used is the Green Pine family of active electronically scanned array (AESA) radars. The iteration of the radar is reported to have a range of 500 kilometers or 310 miles and is capable of both target detection and continuous tracking. The Citron Tree Battle Management and Command, Control, Communication, and Intelligence System serves as the control center for data processing, threat assessment, and mission control. The Battle Management System provides early warning, launch point estimation, and prediction of impact points. The interceptor is developed from the previous Arrow 2. The Arrow 3 has a patented exo-atmospheric interception method, including a two-stage interceptor. Unlike Arrow 2, it uses a hit-to-kill technology, in which the interceptor carries a kinetic kill vehicle that rams into the target, destroying it in the air. An important aspect is that Arrow 3 can be launched within the approximate zone before it's known where the target missile is heading, and when the target's course is identified correctly, it can be redirected to engage it. It's equipped with a gimbaled seeker and has a thrust vectoring nozzle. As per reports, the interceptor is capable of reaching an altitude of 100 kilometers or 62 miles. The missile is thought to have a reported range of up to 2,400 kilometers or 1,500 miles, but the exact details are classified. S-500 Prometi is the latest in Russia's S-series air defense system. While much of the S-500 specs remain classified at this time, the publicly available information suggests that it will be capable of intercepting a wide variety of targets. It's not designed to replace the S-400, but work along with it. S-500 is built with a focus on ballistic threats instead of general air defense against aircraft and cruise missiles. It will eventually replace the current A-135 anti-ballistic missile system deployed in silos around Moscow. While the S-400 has an engagement range of 400 kilometers or 250 miles, the S-500 is thought to have expanded it to 600 kilometers or 370 miles. In May 2018, Russia conducted the longest-range surface-to-air missile test to date with the S-500. According to reports, citing unnamed sources familiar with U.S. intelligence on the program, the S-500 was able to hit a target 482 kilometers or 300 miles away, which is 80 kilometers or about 50 miles further than the previous record. The S-400 is designed to defend against short- and medium-range missiles. The S-500 is designed to combat even intercontinental ballistic missiles. As per some sources, the S-500 system can detect ballistic missiles at a range of 2,000 kilometers or 1,242 miles and warheads of ballistic missiles at a range of 1,300 kilometers or about 810 miles. It may be able to defeat ballistic missiles before their warheads re-enter the atmosphere. S-500 system is said to be capable of tracking 5 to 20 ballistic targets and intercepting up to 5 to 10 ballistic targets simultaneously. This will enable the system to take on a saturation attack from the enemy. GMD is the ground-based mid-course defense system developed by the U.S. to protect against ballistic missiles. It neutralizes incoming ballistic threats by engaging them during the mid-course phase of ballistic trajectory flight in space. Viewers may note that it's not meant to be used against aircraft or cruise missiles and is specifically meant for intermediate-range ballistic missile, or IRBM, and intercontinental ballistic missile, or ICBM, threats. The capabilities of GMD are secretive since it's a very crucial asset. Sensors include ground-based radars, or GBR, upgraded early warning radars, and forward-based X-band radars, FBXB, such as the sea-based X-band platform, and the ANTPY-2. The system has been bolstered with the deployment of new radar capabilities, such as the Long-Range Discrimination Radar, or LRDR, to strengthen detection. The interceptor is called the Ground-Based Interceptor, or GBI, and these are kept in ground-based missile silos located in Fort Greely, Alaska, and Vandenberg Air Force Base, California. The GBI carries the Exo-Atmospheric Kill Vehicle, or EKV, to the desired trajectory. EKV is designed to collide with the incoming missile to destroy it. The system is the most reliable, well-designed BMD system in the world and is expected to take on even advanced ICBMs fired from Russia.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.